Steady democratic gains in both South and Northeast Asia, in the Philippines, South Korea, Taiwan, Indonesia, and most recently in Malaysia, hardly bespeak a region that is inherently authoritarian.
Experience in Malaysia. I'm working in a coalition of forces, the liberal right and the Islamic party and the Justice Party. Now, of course, Carl referred to the rally, yes, but we had a lot of constraints, a lot of roadblocks, and I was given clear warnings and threatened before the speech. Our worry has always been not that we do not have freedom of speech. All countries have. Under Saddam, you have freedom of speech. In Malaysia, you have freedom of speech.
The victory of the three-party opposition alliance led by Anwar Ibrahim in five of Malaysia's 13 states, and the capture of enough seats in the national parliament to deny the government a two-thirds majority represented the biggest loss for the governing National Front since 1957. Asia generally, where Anwar is a deeply respected figure, and in the wider Muslim world where his voice resonates.
In this new century, freedom is once again assaulted by enemies, determined to roll back generations of democratic progress. Once again, we're responding to a global campaign of fear with a global campaign of freedom, and once again, we will see freedom's victory. Then I want to thank you for inviting me back. Thank you for the short introduction. I appreciate Carl Gershom. I want to welcome former Congressman Dick Gephardt, who is a board member of the National Endowment for Democracy. It's good to see you, Dick. And I appreciate Chris Cox, who's the chairman of the U.S. Security and Exchange Commission and a board member for the National Endowment of Democracy, for being here as well. I want to thank all the other board members.